trauma. It is not ideal. The process would surely kill you. But not to worry. Should you transform, I will happily perform a new examination. A Nautiloid? Fascinating. I have never set foot on one myself. They were our warships during the greatest eras of the Illithid Empire. We ruled the entire astral plane from their decks. The design was lost when the Gith rebelled and ended our dominion. Of course. I am sorry I cannot assist you in its removal. But I have an idea.
Oh, perhaps I should start taking notes.
There may be a way to bypass that stasis. There are many alchemical substances that can influence the mind. I do not intend to shatter its protection. I need only bypass the interference that prevents me from communicating with the lava. A tincture distilled from a collection of rare mushrooms. They have subtle psionic influence. I would require a fresh ton of madness and timusk spores. But be warned, in their natural state, both of these mushrooms can be quite dangerous. Timusks cause confusion in those that approach them. The tongue is self-explanatory. These are fine specimens. It will only take me a moment to brew them to proper potency.
Omeluum turns away to prepare the potion, lost in its own musings.
You must drink the entire draught. I can make no promises as to its taste. It will lower the psionic defenses around the lava. If I cannot remove it, I may still be able to tell you more about its origin.
Omeluum watches you with cautious intensity. It expects doubt. It expects fear. The potion is disgusting beyond description. The only mercy is that it goes down quickly.
Not a drop left. Very good. As the potion influences your mind, you may find yourself acting irrationally. Try and stay focused.
The world loses its edges, its finer boundaries. You are fluid, but trapped like a creature suspended in amber. Dance around Omeluum, but you stay steady and staring ahead. The tadpole spasms, seizes. It's fighting the potion even harder than you are. Fear pierces your mind like knives of ice. The parasite digs deeper, as if it means to hollow out your skull. old blades lose their edge. You are stalwart, turning that tide of fear against itself. The parasite swells with power, more power than you have ever felt before. It surges and twists, lashing out against that which would dare to intrude. The parasite in your mind quiets, pleased with itself.
Omeluum, are you well?
That lava is like nothing I have ever observed before. Its power is unsettling. Such an outcome was not in my calculations. There is more to this being than mere stasis. Yet that power may grow beyond your control. I have another intermediate solution, if you are in need. I possess a ring of mind shielding. It prevents elder brains from noticing my presence. It will not remove the lava, but it will limit its influence, both positive and negative. I would offer it as a gift, but in truth, the ring is priceless. Is there anything you could offer me in turn?
As Omeluum watches your performance, something stirs in his mind, unusual for an illithid. Joy.
Here, it is yours. May it serve you as well as it has served me. Of course, the lava remains. Be ever vigilant of its growth.
How is your more personal research?
No one's stopped me yet.
What's next? No harm in a little conversation.
up for discussion.
Welcome back. Have you made any new discoveries? I do enjoy a good bargain. If anything in my private collection is to your liking. Very well. I have mushrooms to catalog.
What's next, I wonder?
Looking ahead. Best be on my way.
Balin, where are you?
It reveals its own home in reply, a humid cove filled with decaying myconid corpses.
Dwegar destroyed my people. I am a sovereign with no circle. This circle does not welcome me. But I have heard the song. You mean to cleanse the Dwegar rot. I mean to join you. must see it for myself. Lead me to the rot. I wish to see it fester. Remain in the Underdark, and I will follow. We cleanse the rot together.
I'll take that. Let's get going.
Excised. The Dwergar are dead. Here I break ground. From the dark will a mighty circle rise. My song will fill the grotto. Death doer. The grotto may sustain but one sovereign. In the age of glut, there may be no spore. Eliminate the other sovereign. A fate it has earned. My circle long suffered while the Dwergar flourished. I sang to Spore for help, yet it cowered in the grotto and let my people be slaughtered. Choose, smooth mind. Help me grow a mighty circle and reap the reward. Or protect the precious poltroon as it waits for the circle of glut to devour it whole. It is my right. It is my right.
Its delicate harmonies turn to scrapes and scratches.
Your corpse will birth my
A sovereign with no subjects. Glut won't be mourned.
Gods are watching me. Just what I need.
It seems the Githyanki are keen to reclaim the artifact I carry. I can't afford that to happen. In fact, none of us can. That thing is shielding us somehow. I don't want to know what happens if we lose it. Agreed. There's not much we can do but press forward. Very serious of you. But go ahead. It's strange. I've been dwelling on what I told you before about wanting to become a Dark Justiciar. But perhaps I should be content with my lot. I'm already blessed to have you at my side, after all. Fine. What's on your mind?
Let's see what this does.
Hmm.
Don't mind if I do.
Gouges.
These things drain away one's magic.
Best be careful.
Flank, outsmart.
Ignis!
Let's end this. Swift and lethal. move. To waste.
Attracting too much attention. testicle.
What's in here?
Thank you.
Something's guarding that forge, and it's weak to this hot hammer.
Wits and blades, always sharp.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
Yes?
Take a gander.
Is that blood? No, never mind. Maybe I need more pockets. Open up. How much farther can I go?
Allow me to demonstrate.
Taking position.
Comes easy these days.
What fools these mortals be.
I'm ready. Victory awaits.
Anything of use?
Quite exhausted. A good night's sleep would do me wonders.
These boots have seen everything. From Waterdeep.
can't afford to stay idle.
Indolence breeds madness. One true way.
No rest for the wicked, I see.
Never wanted the easy path.
The dog pants through a ball held firmly in his mouth. He relinquishes the ball. It is well chewed and slick with drool. His eyes track the ball avidly. He shuffles on his paws, ready to chase after it. Scratch's tongue lolls out happily, his tail wagging even faster.
I want to have a word.
Hope you're keeping well, friend.
It'll take a while for us all to recover, but you've helped us take the first step. Of course. May you keep balance.
first to put my hands on everything.
An offering. A candy sweet scent wafts forth. The sousa bark infuses the weapon from within the flames. The flames sputter away. The sword is complete.
No forging without fire.